Amman is the capital and most populous city of Jordan and the country's economic, political and cultural center. The city has a population of 4 million and a land area of 1,680 square kilometers. Today, Amman is considered to be among the most liberal and westernized Arab cities. It is a major tourist destination in the region, particularly among Arab and European tourists.
This is the Royal Automobile Museum.
Located next to Al Hussein Public Parks, the museum was established in 2003 upon King Abdullah's wishes. The museum showcases a rare collection of Jordan's vehicles, ranging from Hussein bin Ali's cars that came to Amman in 1960s to modern sport cars. This is him?
He have all of these cars?
Yeah.
What he... He drive every day another car?
No, he's a king. Collect a car, classic car. Some of them like a gift.
This is him?
Yes. Before he died.
And his son make this museum, no?
Yes.
When he die, they make funeral for him in this car.
1999, when King Hussein died, and all the presidents of the world, they came to Jordan. This is Clinton, this president for Malaysia, Ahmed bin Rashid Maktoum for Dubai, and Hosni Mubarak, Egypt, Ali Abdullah Saleh from Yemen.
Papa Fatikan visit River Jordan.
In this car?
In this car.
And he sit there?
Yeah.
This was the security for King.
This is one of the king's car, and you are allowed to come inside and take photo.
This one, the only motorcycle in the world. It's the only one.
Desert time. These are king's car for driving in the desert.
Car and go on the sea. You see in the middle?
Mm-hmm.
Like the ship.
Yes. This car can go in the sea. You see here in the mirror, it have this. And this is Petra. These cars are for desert, and we see a lot of dust in this car. So King have car for everything. Really, it surprises me that I didn't see the flying car. Oh, actually, he have a flying car. His personal airplane.
One little kid with a big box walking the street, and we ask what is in the box, and he show us the duck. He sell us duck for 2 GD.
I was in restaurant and I eat hummus and falafel. So from the rest of it, I give 2 duck to eat.
My duck have a new friend. It's girl.
They love each other so much.
I have this bird.
She's very, very smart. And she can't fly. She just walks from arm to arm. Very, very, very cute. Don't bite my eyes.
Here we see Syrian traditional dress and Palestinian traditional dress. This is a men's scarf. And the color for Jordan is red and white. And for Palestine is black and white. I know all of you are familiar with Arabic dance and belly stomach and this stuff, but here they are making it for kids. Welcome to the umbrella stairs. Now we are going in Hashem restaurant. The royal family of Amman is very simply and not so like, oh, we are in the high class. So sometimes they eat in the normal public places for every mortal people. Welcome to Hashem restaurant, and this is the royal family eating. The king, the queen, and their son. So in the Hashem restaurant, you can enjoy in the traditional Arabic food, like hummus, falafel, mutabel, hubez, salad, and of course chai with all of this. Saha.
Hey, thank you.
We see Roman theater right now, but we will not go there. We will go to Jebel al-Qa. It's a citadel in Amman, and we are going to check it. Ugh, boring red lights. Great view of Amman, and we are going in citadel. Amman have a lot of history, and first the city of Amman was called Rabadat Amman. We see here it starts from Hellenistic period up to pottery Neolithic, and then it's named Philadelphia from Byzantine to Nabaean period, and then it's named Amman like now. Here we see the list of occupation of Jordan. We see Roman theater from here. And we are in Jebel al-Qala, in citadel.
Jebel al-Qala, the L-shaped hill, is one of the seven jebels that originally made up Amman. Evidence of occupation since the pottery Neolithic period has been found here in citadel. It was inhabited by different peoples and cultures until the time of Umayyads, after which came a period of decline, and for much of the time until 1878, the former city became an abandoned pile of ruins, only sporadically used by Bedouin and seasonal farmers. Despite this gap, the citadel of Amman is considered to be among the world's oldest continuously inhabited places. The citadel is considered as an important site because it had a long history of occupation by many great civilizations. Most of the buildings still visible at the site are from the Roman, Byzantine, and Umayyad periods.
The major buildings at the site are Hercules Temple, Byzantine Church, and Umayyad Palace. The fortification gates, this is the map of the city. They have towers everywhere and just 1, 2, 3 gates. The fortification wall protects this citadel from the enemies.
This is Hercules, Temple of Hercules. It was like this. This lift?
Hercules is considered like son of the god. So when Christianity come to the Romans, they are not strange to know for idea of someone be son of god. So they had coins, and in these coins they had Hercules in them. But when Christianity come, they sweep away these coins and they make coins with Jesus on them. Constantine bring the Christianity for Romans by dreaming a dream where Jesus told him that he will win with some sign. This is the Temple of Hercules. We find the pieces of the Hercules statue. It was 13 meters high. Because it represents his strength. It was found near the Hercules temple, which means the temple is dedicated to him. And it was one of the largest statues in the Roman period. This is the Hercules hand and his elbow. This is Hercules temple. These two are found near this. And you can read more information by yourself. This is the Byzantine church, 550 AD. This is the place where the priests are performing their summer ceremony, and from that place to here, the people. This is the Umayyad complex. Through these doors we see Umayyad's palace. We will go and check what is there. Here are new. They are here just to represent how it looked before, but they would look like this if they are. They restore it so people can see. The bath or hammam, how they say in Arabic, it's here.
Water tank, a huge water tank.
From the water tank to hammam, water go this road. This is the colonnaded street. We sit here. It's from palace to there. 730 AD. When they made the columns and stuff from the stones, they make shapes. For example, we see this one is kind of bird, this one is bear, and this one is flower, woman. This is how the ancient grave looked like. And these are the plates. We see here early Bronze Age cave / tomb. These are the tombs, how they look like. Here they will bury the people and they will cover it with the big stone, big round stone over it. This place is a cemetery of 20th century. Most graves here predate 1951 and some of them are even in 1970. From here we can see the biggest mosque and the biggest church in Amman, right side to side next to each other. The biggest mosque is King Abdullah I Mosque. It's built in the honor of the King Hussein's grandfather. Hussein's grandfather is King Abdullah I. It's built 1990, and the biggest church is Orthodox Church, and it's built 1964. This is the mosque, and on the left side, it's church. We are heading to the exit, and before I exit, I should warn the people that for Jordanians the price is 0.25, but for tourists, 3 GD, which is huge difference. Hey, we are gonna eat some knafe. Knafe is very sweet, dessert. It's come from Nablus. This is the oldest place to eat knafe in all Amman and Jordan. This place is so popular that we are in the line waiting for our food. There's a big line here. What's knafe with pistachio? Basically, knafe is sweet with cheese. It's very sweet and it's eating hot. Because
This place is very famous. We don't have place to swim. Sit. But it's very delicious. One thing in Jordan now is time for elections. So there is a lot of posters of politic people in the street. And some people are get themselves freedom of choice and they make art from this. This is a real cigarette. Hello, welcome to the Roman Theater. Ajnabi, yani tourists pay 2 GD and locals pay 25 piasters. We are at the end of Roman Theater and we ask for some people, can they speak in the middle of the circle so we can see, can we hear them or no? So now we will try. Shukran!
So beautiful.
We heard her and we are so happy. When I speak something in this circle is in the middle of the theater. So it marks the point where you can speak and the last people from there, they can hear you. But here you cannot see the difference between this circle and when you speak in any another place in the circle. But when you go to Jerash and you stay in the middle of the circle, you can see the vibration, you can see the strongness of your voice and you can feel the vibration through your body. Really, really, you should try it. From Roman Theater next to it, we have museum and we are going to check it.
Everything will be okay.
So this is traditional clothes. This is traditional clothes, huh?
This is explaining
kitchen.
The Bedouin lifestyle. Like you see, everything's on the floor. The woman is making bread. She's making the dough here. Over there, I think the woman is grinding coffee.
So here they are showing the traditional life for people. This man, he's selling the spices. Cleaning shoes, praying, camel, riding.
This is a wedding, actually, the man wedding. And the wife.
This is wife. The woman wash her clothes. The Bedouin life. They are making tea and coffee. Making bread. This is another museum in the another side of this theater. There is some man with cake and he gave me this cake for free.
Bon appétit.
Tasty. So we enter the oldest house in Amman. It's open for visitors. This is downtown of Amman. That home is made 1920. Owner of this house give this house for tourists to come. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. This would be my next video and this is what YouTube recommends for you to watch. You have time to click. 3, 2, 1, bye!